Now we return to two videos ago where we were talking about this joint probability table, and we looked at what happens when we observe that the weather W is equal to rainy and we want the distribution for temperature T. And we saw that we simply had to take this row and renormalize these by dividing each of these by the sum of this row, which was 1/6. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to turn this visual reasoning we had into formulas. Really, just one main formula, but we're going to write a few out so that we know what's going on. Okay, so first off, we now know that the sum of this whole row, 1/6, this, as we saw from the marginalization video, this is actually equal to the probability that W is equal to rainy. Okay, so if we take 1 over 30 and divide by 1/6, this is how we got the probability for hot given rainy. Okay, was we did this calculation. Now we see that this is equal to the probability that W is equal to rainy and T is equal to hot. So rainy hot divided by probability W being equal to rainy. Okay? And similarly, 2/15 divided by 1/6. This thing, so this top thing, this was 1/5 and this was 4/5. This thing is equal to probability of WT being equal to rainy cold divided by PW of rainy. Okay, there's a pattern that's showing up. So this thing here, notationally, we'll write it as the probability that T is the temperature is hot given that, so we'll do given that the weather is equal to rainy. Okay, this thing is going to be new notation that we're going to use to mean this expression here. And similarly down here, we're going to have probability of T given W. So this bar here means given or conditioned on W being equal to some specific value, which is why this procedure is actually usually called conditioning. Okay, so probability of cold given rainy is going to be equal to this bottom guy. Okay? Notice the pattern in the formula. We have cold given rainy is equal to cold and rainy happening divided by the thing we're conditioning on, rainy. And the same was true up here. The probability of hot given rainy is the same thing as the probability of rainy and hot divided by the probability of what we're conditioning on, rainy. Okay? So, in general, we have for random variables x, y with joint probability table p, x, y, we have the probability that x given y, so x being equal to little x and y being equal to little y. This thing is defined to be, I'll do this triangle to mean defined as, the probability, the joint probability of both little x and little y happening divided by the marginal distribution for y evaluated at little y. Okay? So this here is the conditional probability. So this thing here is called the conditional probability of x being equal to little x, given that we're conditioned on y being equal to little y. So in this class, oftentimes, if you remember, we are interested in seeing a table like t being 1/5 for hot and 4/5 for cold. Basically, this table here was the distribution for t given that w is equal to rainy. So the notation we'll use to refer to this table is little p subscript capital T given W parentheses dot, because we want not a specific value for the temperature but the whole table, and then given here this would be rainy. Okay, so moving back down to the general equation, if we want the distribution for x given that y is equal to little y, this has an associated probability table which we denote p x given y of dot given little y. Okay? One final thing is that this probability that y equals little y, this thing cannot be equal to 0. Otherwise, this conditional probability isn't defined. Okay, so in this course, we're only going to be conditioning on things that can possibly happen.